Hello dear students, today we are going to discuss how image formation is studied for a coaxial optical system. Basically by using matrix. Okay, so here we are going to study in the form of a matrix, how can we represent the image formation by an coaxial optical system. Now when we say coaxial optical system means all the lenses and used or spherical refracting surfaces that are being used are basically having a same optical axis. Okay, suppose that we can have a lens like this, then we can have a lens like this, again we can have a lens like this, we can have a lens like this, like that. So there may be number of lenses, okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, again 6, like that. Okay, so we can have number of lenses. So you have the object here, so this is the object, it can be an axial object or non-axial object, and here we are going to have the image. Okay, so as usual, you remember that object is basically represented by lambda 1 x1, where lambda is the angle that is made by the ray of light at that point with the principal axis, and x is the height. Okay, so height of that particular point at which the ray of light is considered at the point O. So similarly here also we have lambda 2 x2, where lambda 1 represents, these things are already described in our previous video lectures. So that is the thing we are going to have. So this is the whole thing is called an optical system, and since all these lenses are having the same axis, okay, so that is why it is called coaxial, okay, optical system. Fine. So we are basically concerned about this object and this is the image. So this is the information that we have, and this is the final information that we need. Okay, so this is the final information, that is, what are the final information, what is lambda 2, what is x2. So then we are not basically very much concerned about what is there in between. Okay, so we may have number of lenses, it can be 2 lens 3 lens 4 lens 5 lens, so there will be number of lenses there. So this whole thing we can represent simply like this. Okay, so instead of considering all the lenses, we will be considering something like this. Okay, let me do it little better, diagram is not looking that good. Okay, so suppose that we have an object here and the ray of light is going an incident on this point at this point BP, and is just before the refraction happens, and you know that there are so many lenses in between them, the ray of light is passing through all the lenses and it is reaching here, and suppose that it is coming out like this. Okay, it is coming out like this, and say this point is called image. Okay, so this is the height x2 and this is the height x1. Fine. So here if I ask you what is the coordinate, it is lambda 1 x1, and this is lambda 2 x2. Okay, so this thing, if we want to represent in matrix form, it will be written as lambda 2 x2. If I want to represent it as matrix form, it will be written as lambda 1 x1. Okay, so that's all we have. So we are not considering all these things in the middle, so these are not necessary, so we will do without them only. Okay, and this point after refraction, okay, it's called Q, and let this height at this point be x dash and this height at this point be x double dash. Okay, so this height is x double dash and this height is x dash. Okay, and I will name this distance. Okay, this distance is d1. Okay, I will name it as, since it is in front of the lens, it is in the left of the lens, it is considered as negative, and this one is considered as positive, so it is d2. All right, so that's all we have. So the whole thing in the middle, this whole thing represents the coaxial optical system. Okay, so in between them, how many lenses are there? We don't know, and we are not at all concerned about that. We are just worried about the initial and final things. Okay, so let us apply all those things mathematically. Sorry. So we will be considering the coordinates, isn't it? So this one is already done, and P is having a coordinate of lambda dash x dash, Q is having a coordinate of lambda double dash x double dash. So that's all we have, and this one is lambda 1 x 1, and this is lambda 2 x 2. So that's all we have. This is not, remember that these things, this is this one, this one, this one, these are coordinates, these are not the matrix. Okay, so we will represent them in the matrix form. Now first of all, for first stage, the ray of light is, first stage, the ray of light is going from O to P. So for OP, what happens? That is called basically translation. Okay, so in OP, this is the initial thing, this is the final stage, isn't it? So P is the final stage, O is the initial stage. So in this side we have O, in this side we have P. So coordinates for, sorry, how to represent O in matrix form? It is lambda 1 x1, and then P is lambda dash x dash. Alright, so here what happens, while going from, we can reach O to P only through what? Translation. So this is a translation matrix. So what we are going to write then? Lambda dash x dash translation matrix, how does it look? 1, 0, this is always 1. So it is actually D by N1, isn't it? So we need to correct it. First of all, check what is the distance here. It is minus D1. So it is minus, let me do that. So it is minus D1 by, so what is that thing here? This thing is nothing but air. Okay, so this effective index is equal to 1, because the here it is air. Okay, so on this side also this is air only. Fine, so effective index is 1. So in here we can write 1. Fine, so it is equal to lambda 1 x1 final. So next thing, so this is the question number 1. Next, for see, now next stage is P to Q. Okay, so for P to Q, now see what happened here between P to Q. So obviously first thing that might have happened is, suppose that this is a lens. Okay, then obviously first thing that happened is refraction. Then suppose that there is another lens. Okay, so here refraction happened, but in between what happened? Translation. Okay, suppose that there is another lens. Okay, so from here what happened? Translation, then here refraction, again translation, then again refraction. So there is a number of refraction and translation happening. So I will remove this thing, as these are not necessary. So for P and Q, it is a combination of refraction and translation. So this thing is basically mirror. So we don't know exactly what happened. So we will represent this by, represent it with the help of a system matrix, or you can say that ABCD matrix. When you don't have any clue regarding how many lenses are there, how many reflections, how many translations happened, so then it is better to use a system matrix or ABCD matrix. So here P is the initial state and Q is the final state. So what is the coordinate for P? It was, I think, lambda dash x dash. and it was lambda double dash x double dash. Okay, and here it will be what? ABCD matrix. So it is A, B, C, D, and these are negatives. Okay, so these are general. So this is equation number 2. Next, 4. For Q2I, I think. So next thing is QI. So let us go back to the diagram. So what happened? Between Q2I, so it is goes like that, so it is going like that, so it is nothing but what? Translation. Fine. So here what happens? It is the translation. So if you want to represent, so Q is the initial state, I is the final state. So if I want to write what is the coordinate for Q, lambda double dash x double dash, and here it is lambda 2 x 2, and the thing that happened is nothing but translation. So we know that the translation matrix is 1 0, here it is 1, and it is basically d by n, isn't it? So in this case, what is the distance? So in this case, distance is d2, all right. And what is the refractive index? 1, because this is air. So what we can write here? So it is simply d2 by 1. So it is lambda double dash x double dash lambda dash, sorry, x2 lambda 2 x2. Okay, so or you can write down lambda 2 x2 is equal to 1 0 d2 1. So that's all we have. Okay, so that is our equation number 3. So see, we have got our equation number 3. So let me write it down again simply. So first thing that we have is lambda dash x dash is equal to 1 0 minus d 1 1 lambda 1 x 1. Then we have lambda double dash x double dash is equal to a b c d, and this is lambda dash x dash. Okay, this is equation number 1. This is equation number 2. Okay. And then we have lambda 2 x 2 is equal to 1 0 d 2 1 lambda double dash x double dash. This is equation number 3. Okay. So, in place of this thing, can we write this value? Okay, used to. So it will be 1 0 d 2 1. It will be b minus a minus d c and lambda dash x dash. Okay, we used 2. Okay, so from 2. Fine. Now this is our lambda 2 x 2. Now again, this thing, can we put it from here, from equation 1? Yes, obviously. So I will make some space. X2 is equal to 1 0 d 2 0 b minus a minus d c, and lambda dash x dash is nothing but 1 0 minus d 1 1 0 minus d 1 sorry 1. Okay, lambda 1 x 1. Now you see, this is the final stage means y, and this is the initial stage means object. Okay, so if you multiply all of them, I will not show the multiplication here. This is to be done by you at home to check the values whether they are correct or not. So it will come up to b a d 1, then it will be minus c and b d 2 plus a d 1 d 2. You can do multiplication and you need to check this, because what I understand that you can't remember the whole thing for examination purpose. So it is better to do it so that if you miss an exam, somehow if you forget, then you can note it down. So it is a suggestion from my side to do the metric multiplication on your own. This is a metric multiplication. Do it on your own. You just match the result. Okay. So lambda 2, x 2. So if I multiply them, it will be b plus a d 1 lambda 1 minus a x 2. Sorry, this is incorrect. This is x 1. Okay. Then b d 2 plus a d 1 d 2 c d 1 minus d. So this is lambda 1 plus c minus a d 2. This is x 1. Okay. So this is the whole matrix. Now we can compare the element. This element is equal to this element. This element is equal to this element. Okay. So what we are left with is, so lambda 2 is equal to b plus a d 1 lambda 1 minus a x 1. And similarly we have x 2 equal to b d 2 plus a d 1 d 2 c d 1 minus d lambda 1 plus c minus a d 2 x 2. Okay, so that would be our equation number 4, and this one is equation number 5. So this is, sorry, I'm not supposed to do this, so it was a mistake. So this is 4 and this is 5. Fine, but you know that for an axial point object. So let us go back to a diagram. Okay, so if the object is a axial point object, okay, axial point object means the object will not be here, okay, the object will be here. So here x1 is nothing but equal to 0. So for an axial point object, the image is also at the axis, so x2 is also equal to 0. So that means for an axial point object, x1 equal to 0, so x2 image will also be formed in the axis. Okay, so x2 is also equal to 0. So if we apply that thing, okay, if we apply that thing on equation number 5, okay, see, equation number 5 implies 0 is equal to b d2 my plus a d1 d2 c d1 minus d lambda 1. Okay. And this thing is equal to again 0, isn't it? This is x1. So it is equal to 0. So lambda 1 can never be equal to 0. So only option left is b d2 plus a d1 d2 c d1 minus d is equal to 0. Okay. So you can see that this thing, let it be equation number 6. So this whole thing is here in this particular. So I will name it as, say, equation number A, okay, because we missed one equation, so I'm just naming it. So this thing is basically representing the matrix which connects the image to the object. Okay, so this here, what happens, this whole thing becomes equal to what? 0. So we can write, so using 6 in equation, sorry, in matrix equation A, we have, okay, so what remains then, lambda 2 x 2 is equal to, we have b a d 1 then minus a, then it is equal to 0, then c minus a d 2, okay, and it is lambda 1 x 1. So that is our equation number 7. All right, so Now from there, from this particular thing, so if I multiply this again, okay, if I do the multiplication for this thing again, so lambda 2x2 will be equal to, so it is b plus a d1 lambda 1 minus a x1, and then it is 0 plus c minus a d2 x1. Okay, so again we can compare this to, all right, and this one to this one. So we can get x2 equal to c minus a d2 x1. So can we write x2 by x1 equal to c minus a d2? Okay, so you see this thing represents the connection between image. So we have got the information about the image. If we have the information about the object, and it changes like this, so the matrix which transform the object, the image, is this one. So we are supposed to derive this. Okay, this is our aim that we have finalized. Okay, now if you want to get the magnification, so this is nothing but the magnification. So it is c minus a d2. Fine. So that's all for the matrix that for the formation of image by an optical coaxial optical system. And the note for which has already been shared in the Google Classroom, so you can easily verify the derivation along with the note. And if you have any difficulty in understanding this derivation, just let me know through WhatsApp or phone call or email or in Google Classroom itself. Thank you.